So I don't want to freak anyone out, but I think we just made a Star Wars movie.
Action.
I just have one goal, which is to make the most powerful Star Wars movie I possibly can.
Once we decided that we were making Star Wars movies, he was one of the people that I was immediately interested in.
I looked into his eyes and I saw conflict.
You have to lay down all your chips in front of a lot of really good poker players.
I trust him. I have to trust him.
Feels really nice to put Luke Skywalker in front of a camera.
I think it's just beginning to dawn the sheer scope of this project, which is enormous.
Beautiful. Good, good, good.
It's really House of Cards. Everything needs to be, like, so perfect, you know, to get it done.
I got really scared.
Every single decision is personal to him.
The best shot at making something good is to come into it and trust my guts, you know.
It's nice, right?
Yeah.
You like it?
I love it. Yeah. Now let me see if I can remember the controls.
Tally, they've targeted the Sraken Manikadukas and Black Fonseca.
Oscar isn't seeing this, is he?
You cannot escape the paw.
Oh, I don't know how he'll react.
You cannot escape the paw.
I broke your gun, I'm so sorry.
What? We got through it.
Yeah.
Oh. Half an hour later. Oh, yo. That sounded epic.
No, their biohexacrypts are rescrambled every hour.
I know, biohexacrypt.
Biohexacrypt.
No, they're biohexacrypts and rescrambled every hour. Oh, they're biohexacrypts and no. They're biohex. No, they're biohex. They're biohexacrypton. No, they're biohexapec. Sorry.
Baker 118, take six.
I mean, you know what it's like. I feel like Grandpa Simpson now. Yeah, let me get out of the cockpit. I don't know what's going on here. All right.
Oh, there's the old targeting device.
Yeah, you don't need that.
No, I don't need that.
Action.
You're demoted.
Wait, for what?
We're demoted.
58, take two.
Background.
Take three.
You're demoted.
Baby?
Yeah, this whole place is beautiful. Sorry, I got something hanging out of my bum.
You have to give Finn and Poe.
That's me.
That's the take.
All right, well, thanks for the memories.
Disobedient, disrespectful, traitor!
You call for order. You beat us down. But when your shiny neck was threatened, you squealed like a whoop hog. The evidence blew up at the base, but you and I know the truth. When I put a gun to your head, you shut down Starkiller Shields. Now, what would your troops do if they found out? Or your masters?
Who would believe a story like that?
You were always scum.
We're
Rebel scum.
Snoke is that very strong bad guy. There's a bad guy sitting there, and he looks like a bad guy, and he's got just evil intentions, and he's exactly what the story requires him to be. You need the monster. You're gonna have your villain be a little more complex.
Give me everything.
Ryan said to me very early on, I want to ground him back in reality. I want him to be a character that the other characters in the film can actually respond to and actually relate to.
There was no hiding it. We just had to do a full CG character that completely held up to scrutiny. And I was very wary of that. I was very, very concerned.
Come closer, child. So much strength. Darkness rises and light to meet it. I warned my young apprentice that as he grew stronger, his equal in the light would rise. Skywalker, I assumed. Wrongly. Closer, I said.
Underestimate Skywalker and Ben Solo and me. It will be your downfall.
Follow my lead.
It was fun getting to see Kylo kind of be a badass pilot and realizing, oh yeah, he comes from that stock. He's his father's son. Okay, you're a great pilot. You're a badass pilot. You're blowing everything up. But then, of course, instantly having him butt up against that moment with Leia. Now you have your mother in your sights. What are you going to do now? We'll just get in tighter and tighter, and we'll just take it up through when you make the decision not to fire on her.
My son, that idiot boy of mine, he almost kills me. But he stops himself right before he's going to kill me, because redundant, don't kill both your parents. It's never a good idea.
We took out a dreadnought.
At what cost? There are some things that you cannot solve by jumping in an X-wing and blowing something up.
That first battle sequence shows his Achilles heel, which is that he wants to be the hero.
But his old heroics aren't necessarily what is needed at this moment.
It's like when someone drops a hard truth on you and you reject it immediately just because you're not ready to learn that yet, you know?
Okay.
Yeah. The theme of mentors runs through this whole series, and to me, it made a lot of sense that Leia would be that to Poe.
Poe is her protege, and in a way, I think she thinks of him as Han. He's very dominating, and he doesn't listen to her. So we have some moments together.
You're demoted.
Whoa, wait!
That was one of the first things that we shot, and I think we did 24 takes. That was very surreal to be slapped by Princess Leia repeatedly.
There's more feistiness this time. That I really like. Now there is Leia again.
Luke is closed off to the Force when we first meet him, and that made sense to me for a lot of reasons. I needed to find a way into why he's on that island that wasn't just him hiding and being a coward. So the thing that would make sense to me is if he's actually come to realize that the galaxy thinks it wants the Jedi back. But the Jedi have done nothing but add to the problems of the universe. And the most selfless act he can do is to do what he couldn't do in The Empire Strikes Back and ignore the calls of help from his friends and lock himself off. And suddenly it turns to this kind of burden that he has to hold. He would love to jump back in and help everybody, but he's realized that if he brings the Jedi back into this, then the Sith are going to rise up again, and the whole thing is going to start again, and it's just going to be more misery.
And then, of course, became like the challenge, what's their red stuff? What's it going to look like, and how are we going to do it?
Ryan had it in his head exactly what he wanted to see, and we tried everything from, you know, red rubber going up in the air, red ice, red snow. All right, let's do it again.
Guys, reload. Go for a bit more water this time.
It took a lot of resources until we came up with something that Ryan was happy with.
Okay, here we go. Oh, that's by far the best.
That's easily the best.
Yeah, there's some nice, quite nice lumps dropping there around.
It's shredded paper, dyed red.
We're on the great battlefield, and this is the opening day on this set.
We've laid down what we're calling the fractals, the things that occur in salt flats when the water dries out and the evaporation cracks the surface.
I'd probably leave a little bit of a delay with that one so we can see them.
I was thinking also, Ryan, that that's a blue screen through the opening there to see through to the next trench.
Perfect. And
action, firing away. 3, 2, 1.
A big part of what defines those original movies is the feeling that you could reach out and touch anything. Given that, there's a tremendous amount of CG in the movie. And Kevin Jenkins and I, designing a new walker was kind of our white whale. The walker is one of the coolest designs in all of science fiction cinema. And Kevin was the one who eventually came up with the notion of the gorilla walker.
It's an iteration rather than a redesign. You know, they took down AT-ATs with snow speeders. What can we do about it? And that's the original one where I was trying to get the pose done.
There's actually a power that this thing projects by being on its knuckles and having this forward lunging kind of like feel. It's still the walker, but this thing feels meaner. To bring Luke to this ending. I didn't want it to be a violent defeat. I wanted it to be a peaceful win. Peace and purpose were the defining words for that scene.
This is based on a very specific shot Ryan wanted of Luke in the foreground, Kylo coming down his shuttle. Ryan referred to this Ralph McQuarrie painting of a probot from Empire Strikes Back. He just loved the palette, he loved the look of it. He said, let's take that painting and see if we can kind of find the emotion behind it.
Working on the design of Crate, I wanted creatures that felt indigenous to the planet. I wanted something that felt like it was part of the landscape and that it really belonged there.
And his starting point that he gave us was to think of a creature that had taken on its environment physiologically and biologically into its body. So this is one of the early designs. Then I responded to Ryan's feedback about choosing something more elegant and beautiful with this design. Once this design was signed off, It became about seeing how that would practically work on a live animal. Because Ryan was always very interested in the idea of it being a practical effects thing as well as a CG thing.
How's your hand? You should see the other guy.
Tell me a little bit about working with Ryan.
I know you've heard good things about him, but he's very tough. No.
And then now slowly...
He just has a very specific vision. And he doesn't seem like that when you first meet him. He doesn't have a dominating sort of affect.
That's great.
But he has a dominating... vision.
This is so simple, but this is so important. So this is basically, I didn't feel like we got like a hero introduction for you for the very first shot. So all this is a turn to camera. It's a really essential one.
He's really good with structuring things in story, and then he's good at working with actors. So he has flaws in other areas. I just don't know about them.
Action. Hold for applause. That was great. Cut. Yeah.
Hello.
Look at this magic. Look at this magic.
One thing's for sure, it has to look like it's on the knees, like it's resting. Otherwise, it looks like you're about to do a baton act.
Like this.
Yeah, right, exactly. One, two, three. Young Skywalker.
Yes, it's really getting to me. Hello.
Frank, we're spying on you. You have spies here.
Oh my God. I'm still upset that he hasn't aged a day. And I've aged tragically.
But you look gorgeous.
Thank you. I've always wanted to be able to do this.
You look handsome.
Like a certain character of yours.
Hi, I'm Ryan Johnson, and I wrote and directed Star Wars: The Last Jedi. Everything about the experience with John Williams was magical. Hear that 100-piece orchestra light up and to feel that music hit you. It's an emotional experience unlike anything I've ever had. The way that he expresses every little nuance, not just of like the big action stuff that's happening, but also the beats of the scenes, the emotional intent of certain lines of dialogue. The way that you could focus on that when you clear everything else out, I just thought, this is amazing. I've been making a Star Wars movie for the past 3 years. I've had my morning coffee on the Millennium Falcon. I've done some pretty cool stuff. And nothing compares to sitting there next to John when he's at work. Which is why I am thrilled to present this score-only version of Star Wars: The Last Jedi. Exclusively on Movies Anywhere.
We're the very last of the Resistance. We need Luke Skywalker.
I'm not coming back.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
That was a cheap move.
We need you to bring the Jedi back. Kylo Ren is strong with the Force.
What do you know about the Force?
It's a power that Jedi have that lets them control people and make things float.
Impressive. Every word in that sentence was wrong.
Ah, Skywalker, missed you, have I?
Oh, they hate that ship!
Rebellion is reborn. The war is just beginning. And I will not be the last Jedi.